Osteoporosis is a condition of bone loss typically associated with aging, and there are some conditions that can increase the chance of having osteoporosis, like menopause or certain medical conditions. The reason we worry about osteoporosis is that it's associated with a high risk of fractures. So when a person is aging and maybe at risk for falling, obviously if you fracture your hip or your back, then that can lead to lots of pain and disability. I would say the first step in preventing osteoporosis is actually being screened for osteoporosis. So knowing what is your bone density. So that is a test called a DEXA scan, which is done typically in the doctor's office and is usually covered by insurance based upon your age and other medical history. And that test can tell us how your bone density compares to an average 30-year-old person. And based upon that information, we can determine if an individual is at increased risk for fracture or not. So there are no other symptoms from osteoporosis. So if you don't have a bone density test, then you really don't know how your bone density reading is. And there are people that I have taken care of who had very significant osteoporosis and had no prior knowledge of that. So unlike, say, osteoarthritis, which can cause pain, osteoporosis is an asymptomatic condition until you have a fracture. So I would say getting screened is important, and then depending on your test results, discussing treatment options, which may be as simple as exercise and vitamin D, taking some calcium, or as complex as either an oral or injectable medication. Certainly, you know, good health habits, not smoking, regular exercise, taking some vitamin D, drinking milk if you like it. Those are some simple things you can do. Some of it are factors that may be beyond our control, such as heredity, other medical problems. Your body type and your body weight are factors as well. So some of it may be out of your control, but on the other hand, there are always factors that can be modified. There are, some of them are lifestyle measures, such as taking a supplement of vitamin D. Weight-bearing exercise like walking or weightlifting can be helpful. And taking calcium or eating calcium-rich foods in your diet. So I would say those are the minimum preventative measures. Beyond that, you're looking at more medically appropriate therapies. Some of it is just avoiding certain things, like not taking prednisone or not smoking. So those are factors that I would say hopefully your doctor is advising you about as you're in your adult years.